Welcome everyone to our Women History Month. I am starting the recording now. Mary Dunn has served as Executive Director of the Henderson Christian Community Outreach for 10 years. This 35-year-old agency assists Henderson County families in need with grocery, shopping, and finance assistance is eligible. Mary and her family of 100 plus volunteers continue to empower, not enable, Henderson County families through the wake of cause of life. In March, the Henderson Christian Outreach, Community Outreach, you got the initials here, so I'm trying to make sure, family will move to their new home on 509 Fifth Street, where the family will continue serving God by serving others. Mary is blessed as the mother of three children and two grandchildren. Mary is a member of Community Baptist Church, where she has served as a deacon chair and currently serving as a deacon. Mary is a member of the Chamber and Rotary and was awarded the Service Above Self Award, as well as being named the Kentucky Colonel. Like I said, thank you for attending the Women History Month event. My name is Dr. Michelle Chappelle. I'm the Diversity, Equity, Inclusion Coordinator, and now I'm going to turn it over to Mary. Sorry, people are trying to enter the room and I'm trying to make sure I get all the pop-ups there.
Well, hello everyone.
Hello.
Let me just tell you. On a Sunday afternoon, if Dr. Chappelle is shopping at Walmart, do not go in there, because I'm shopping with my husband and I hear, Mary, Mary. That is why I'm here. I am not a public speaker, but here we go. I am blessed beyond blessed to be here with these powerful women and these two powerful men that are brave enough to come in here. So as we celebrate Women's History Month, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to have everybody stand up that's in here. Like Dr. Chappelle said, my name is Mary Dunham. I am the mother of three kids. And this is how we're going to do this. If you are 60 and above, you may sit down, because we deserve it.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. See, I could be sitting down right now. If you're 50, between 50 and 60, you may sit down. Oh my goodness. If you're 40, between 40 and 50, you guys don't even know what's going on. If you're between 30 and 40, you may sit down. And if you're 20 and under, 20 and 30, you may sit down. Okay. Well, this is all I'm going to say. Come on, Miss Cindy, Cindy Evans and Debbie Inyard. I know them too. This is what I'm going to say at age 63. There's many, many, many wake-up calls that we have to get through this life. So, and there's several powerful women that I owe where I am to. And for that, I'm blessed. So, of course, it wouldn't be right to start this without saying thank you to my mom. What a hard worker. I remember growing up in a small town in North City, Illinois. Anybody know where that's at?
No.
1,200 people, Mr. Pritchett, 1,200 people. Mama was such a hard worker, and so was Daddy. But this is the deal. When you were born, you think you've got the life of a princess. And I did. I had parents that loved me. However, I didn't know we were poor. I had no idea we were poor. I thought everybody had RC and bologna sandwiches on Friday night as a special treat. I didn't realize way back then, when Daddy worked for the state of Illinois, that we were poor. So what happened? When I was born, Mom and Dad had already adopted a brother and a sister, my brother and sister. They adopted this, my brother and sister, from a local family that were alcoholics. So I was the only child they had, naturally. Well, what happens through your life, ladies, especially you youngins, what happens way back then shapes where you're going to end up. And so fast forward to age 15. This is why I ask if there's no children in the room. There was some sexual abuse in our home. So what did I do at age 15? I got pregnant, had to quit school to get out of my house. It is what it is. And I think this is a natural path to where I am now. So I had my oldest son at age 16. We stayed together 19 years, my husband and I did. My oldest son has a master's degree. He has already retired from one job. He's, you know, they live in Fishers, Indiana. He's just a phenomenal young man. So, girls, you got to do that. Pat yourself on the back. Now, when I did decide to get a divorce, this is where God stepped in. I did a lot of things that I'm not very proud of. Had an affair. Got a divorce. In your 30s, ladies, just be careful if you've not been there yet. Because, thank you, God, even though I was hospitalized twice with anxiety and just different things, I did find a second husband. And if you all know John Dunham, that's all I'm going to say. So at age 39, well, actually at age 37, we were married. I was pregnant, and unfortunately, I lost that baby. Now, for you women that haven't got there yet, I was 37 and pregnant after having a child at 15. So unfortunately, we lost our first baby, which was another wake-up call. I mean, you're like, God, I'm sorry, I sinned, so on and so forth. But we got over that. And then I got pregnant with Kelsey. Kelsey, you're my love, you know that. My daughter, I had her at age 39. There's something special about a bond between a mother and a daughter. Now, let me tell you, when I was pregnant, I worked at the Courier and Press, and that's the first group of people I'm going to thank, the women at the Courier and Press. 18 years I was with this group of women. Anybody know Felicia Grounds? Okay, you know Felicia Grounds? She put me in my place one day. And I worked 9 years in advertising and 9 years in marketing. So when I say that, be sure and listen for the people that put you in your place, because you're going to need it. So I was all that. I was in advertising. I was a salesperson. I'd go out and make those sales calls in my little tight skirt. That was way, way back before these pounds came on. But anyway, when I came back in, I had to design the advertising, right? So I asked Felicia, who was the secretary in the advertising department, to help me with some things. Only I didn't ask her nicely. Woo! I said, do this, do that. And I turned around and walked back to my desk, and she said, and you're welcome. It stopped me in my tracks. And that's when I started using the term, how dare you. I don't use how dare you. I used it to me. How dare I think I was all that? How dare I? So that was a wake-up call, I'm telling you. The next group, I'm getting to a point, I promise you, because this is why I love my job right now. Because some of the people we see need to hear this kind of thing. So then after I lost my job at the Courier and Press, some of you know, some of you don't know, our family hit rock bottom. Because we were living way above our means. My husband was a photographer for 30 years. He eventually lost his job in the newspaper. I lost my job after 18 years. We were that perfect family that wanted everything for our kids. We were living way above our means. We had a $1,250 a month house payment. God, who does that? But guess what? We found this out in 2020 when COVID hit. Don't live above your means. Because we hit rock bottom. We had to sell our house. And God says, oh, I don't think you guys have learned enough. Let me just let you do this sale in the lawyer's office. But this guy wanted to move right on in our house. Oh, I was so stupid back then. So we moved out, let him move in. He made our payments for a couple of months, and then guess what? He quit answering our calls and texts. We had to get the sheriff to get him out of our house. Anyway, fast forward. No, fast forward. This is nothing, honey. This is nothing. This is nothing. So with the wake-up calls, you know, we weren't living for the right reasons still. Girls, I was in my, by then, I was about 45. No, I was older than that. About, I don't even know. Anyway, we moved to a rent house. We had no air conditioning. It was Father's Day weekend. It was hot. And Kelsey and Jake and John and I, we slept on a mattress in one bedroom from our three full bath house. Anyway, all these wake-up calls get you where you want to go. So I did get a job at Central Learning Center for 2.5 years before I took the job at the Courier Press. So the next group of women I need to thank are the ladies at Central Learning Center, because I had been at the Courier Press for 18 years. I was in my own little tunnel vision, didn't know we had to have an alternative school with kids that really, really needed people. Loved every minute of it. Loved every minute of it. Ryan Rushmont was my principal, dear friend still to this day. He allowed me to do a school newspaper. These children that I taught at Central Learning Center, these are the families we're seeing now with 4 or 5 kids. And it's just amazing that they still say, Miss Dunham. And I said, yes, whatever your name is. I wrote you up many a times. And this is, come up to my table. I think we need to talk. But anyway, that was, thank you, those powerful women. Thank you for those powerful women. Well, then selfishly, I needed a job part-time to take care of parents that were sick. We've all, you young ones may not be there yet, but most of us have had to take care of sick parents. So I took the job at Christian Community Outreach as a part-time person, 20 hours a week, so I could take care of my husband's dad that was sick at that time. And all I'm gonna say about this is we've lost Pop. We've lost my brother and sister. I'm no different than anybody else in this room. These are all things that shape you to where you're going to be. So the ladies of Christian Outreach, no offense, gentlemen, but we are powerful women. And if you're involved or volunteer or on the executive committee and you're with Christian Outreach, I need you to stand up, please. And thank you for being here. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. All right, Dr. Chappelle, so where do we go from here? Do we
for want the next slide?
Yes, please.
Okay.
And
I'm her Vanna White.
You are my Vanna White. I will never talk to you in Walmart again. So as the story goes, this agency has been in town since 1986. Our dear Barbara Butler, who we just lost last week, she was on the founding committee. What a strong, powerful woman. Do you know Barbara Butler? She passed last week. This agency was created way back then to help low-income folks just make it month to month. So when I hired in, y'all know it was in the barbershop at one time, Red's Barbershop, and then it was in the little blue building, and that's where I hired in. I believe, Melissa, that's where I met you. Melissa with United Way in the little blue building. Okay, now, for my sisters out here, let me tell you, I was so green when I walked into that building. But I did see a vision, and I was so green because we had all these volunteers, and there was one group that came in on a certain day, and they were all from the same church. And at that time, it was not, as this purpose statement says, to respond with dignity and concern. It was to throw stuff in a box and shove it to you. And then all my African-American families or Hispanic families kept coming up to me. Miss Mary, how come we didn't get meat? Oh, it has, mistake. but it kept happening, but it only happened on one certain day of the week. So I started going to their cars. Now this is only 10 years ago, 10 years. And sure enough, if you were Hispanic or Black, you didn't get meat. God help us. So here we go. So that's our purpose. You said you wanted to touch this, not me.
Okay. Look,
you're making me nervous.
I'm making you nervous. So you know what? It's all about dignity and concern. Our families come in and shop every 30 days. You all know this. I'm going to skip through this. We're not doing family size right now because we are so busy. The grocery prices, it is no secret. We are so busy that we can't keep up with things. Y'all know we have wonderful grocery partners. Senior commodity program, y'all are aware of this. Awesome. Funding assistance. This is where it gets a little bit tricky. Funding assistance, when I first started, our budget was about $85,000 a year for our families. After the end of this year, we're at $282,000 for our families, for our budget. 2019 hit, and that's when we had our land donated for the new building. We went into 2022, and it was a whole new world. It was a world that I never thought, as the director of Christian Outreach, I would have to dive into. And this is where all these additional partners came in. Never have I ever had to deal with the corner. And we were talking earlier that there is a funeral today for a young man here in Henderson that has just gave up, committed suicide. And so that shook me to my core. And that's when I started praying to God, okay, let me, when I talk to these people, pull from what all has happened to me and see if I can help. And sure enough, you know, the grief counseling, my anxiety problems, everything that I had been through, I noticed when we talk to people that it works. And that's, I am not a licensed counselor. I've never said I was a licensed counselor, but you know what? People are just wanting to hear. They just need a friend. So we do help with utility, rent, medication, emergency gas for out-of-town doctor visits. The numbers, you can see in utility assistance, 2020 was not our best year. 2020 is when I had the opportunity to have Kelsey come on board with us. Kelsey graduated in the midst of COVID from Georgetown College. The Henderson Employee Relief Fund was formed. Lisa's going, oh. If you're not familiar with the Henderson Employee Relief Fund, in about a week, we were presented with about $400,000 to assist those people that had been laid off from Tyson, Gibbs, Audubon Metals, so on and so forth. And so when Bill Fidler asked me, as I was driving on the bridge, he said, can you and your agency take care of this? And I said, no way. No, Bill, love you, but no, thank you. And I said, but if you hire Kelsey, she can be over the spreadsheet. But it took every one of us, because every employer out of 787 applications had to be called, because y'all know there's that 5% that just might not want to tell the truth to try to get some money. No secret. However, we only had 21 families that didn't get funded with that money, and that's pretty good. So back to what we're seeing every day now. Rent, we still have the same problems. We had several problems this morning. As Dr. Chappelle said when we walked in, how's your day? No, and this is just one situation. Two women that are both homeless, but they got out of the same vehicle and they're living out of their car. But, you know, and when I said, But y'all don't have jobs. When's the last time either one of you worked? One of them was close to getting escorted out until her friend said, you need to leave, which was probably a good thing. Come on, let's be serious. As we move to the new building and as we plan to empower our families, it's not going to get any better. You know, it's normal. I have not enjoyed working every one of my 46 years, but I'm working, right? So it's the norm to have a job and to take care of your family. And I don't think there's anything wrong with doing that. As I see Cindy back there, I'm going to tell this story real quick. How am I doing on time?
Good.
Okay. Cindy and Debbie are from First Christian. They started yet another shopping time for grocery shopping. You know, we do Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, third Saturday of the month. And that's all 9 to 11 in the morning. And what we have found out that some of our families can't quite function that early, 9 to 11. Because, you know, we're tired, our volunteers are tired when they get there at 11:30 and think, I'm the only person in the world, I need food. Well, you're late. So we did start opening from 4 to 6 in the evening the first Thursday of the month, and that'll be this Thursday. Because there are so many people that work, possibly not a great paying job, but they work and they still need our help. So the first Thursday of the month, we're open 4 to 6. Well, then Miss Debbie comes in and she says, hey, I've got a group of women and we can open one time in the afternoon. And so here we are. The third Thursday of the month, we're open from 1 to 3 p.m. Fran Pangle, who's not here, she came up to me and she said, Cindy and I would like to do a program in the new building for folks that can't read. Yes, there are still folks that can't read. And that's why the dignity and respect when you come in, when you have a personal shopper to walk through with you to grocery shop, what if you can't read? What if you have anxiety so bad you can't function in our food pantry? What if, what if, what if? And so we had a young man that came to Darlene Marshall Ware's last Wednesday class. I'm not sure if she knows which one I'm talking about, but he needed help with rent. When I got him back there for his personal interview, we had helped him stay at the Holiday Motel. Come to find out, he can't read. He is 30, Cindy, do you remember, 36, 30? He's in his 30s. Our agency set him up to fail because at that time he wasn't prepared to get a job. We sent him, if you all know how we do this, if you need assistance, financial assistance, you are required to take the budgeting class on Wednesday, which we are blessed beyond measure to have Darlene Marshall Ware teach every one of our classes. Because we feel like we have been friends for 10 years. We feel like you have to keep it as real as possible. We've got too many women losing the roof over their heads, no offense, men, because they move a boyfriend in and they lose. We have had women that we tell them, do not, when he gets out of prison, do not take him back in your house. Well, he did, and he broke her leg in 8 places, and so on and so forth. Domestic is alive and well, so now we're dealing with that. When we teach this class, when I was interviewing him, JOS staffing is always on site to try to help people who don't have jobs. This young man got a job the next, I think it was on a Friday. We sent him to Budge Industries. He made it one day. We're like, oh. So we, Mark said, I see something in him. I'm going to move him to Moy Carpet. The first thing they did was to ask him to cut carpet. He can't read numbers. So that poured out at the table the other day. And I said, I'm sorry, we set you up for failure. And it just pushed him down farther. Now, I have contacted a counselor for him because he definitely needs a counselor. Because his wife has left him now and so on and so forth. So all these barriers keep coming up. I'm way off rent, but that's okay. Family served. Guys, it is not. Look at 2021. Look at 2021. Now, this is all of our food, our extra food orders at the church, our grocery shopping hours, our senior service program, but it is not getting any better where we are. Ugh. For United Way, you know, we have got to stop this emergency lodging. Can you all see that okay? Mm-hmm. Emergency lodging, these hotel stays. 2019, we spent $1,083. 2020, $9,900. Last year, $22,000 went to emergency lodging. Now that this agency cannot keep doing this. However, right now we have a father, Spotsville school call. Father lived with brother. He's the sole caretaker of an autistic child. Brother got evicted. We've got him at the Sugar Creek Inn for a week, and then I'm not sure what's going to happen. He has disability, but mama gets the child's disability, and she's in Ohio. We can't turn people like that away, but we sure can turn the people that can't pass a drug test away. I'm sorry, God, but that's just the way it is. You are here at this agency for the wrong reason. And so if you don't know, we do drug tests now with Involvement Inc. We work very closely with the judges here in town. We work very closely with Steve Goad in the county attorney's office. You know what? If you write a bunch of bad checks way back when, it's going to eventually catch up to you. Don't come in here and scream at me. No, because you're not using our money to go to the county attorney's office. But we sent a check over there because we wanted to see how far the lies would go. I had to walk her out of the building. No, this, your fault, your fault. Now, we do a Christ-like, so don't get excited. So there's our new building. So let me look on my list here. The women in our lives and the men. I mean, I'm very blessed to be able to do this. So there's our new building. But for you all that have not seen our slideshow from where we were, we're going to show that very quickly. If you want to get that movie up. Now, at the beginning here, Michelle, you wanted to ask me why I have these?
Yes, you can go ahead and do that.
Okay. Well, I have these because I am 63 years old and I have to have glasses to read. And I catch myself carrying three pair at a time now because Kelsey got tired of me saying, your glasses are on the table or your blah, 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 blah. Larry Butler starts this. If you don't know Pastor Butler, our prayer room is in his memory in our new building because this was his wish. I'm ready.
Oh, okay.
Heavenly Father, we love you so much. God, we just pray that your blessings upon us as we've come today. God, we're so blessed to have a place like this in Henderson where we can minister to people who have needs in their lives. God, we can show your love to them by showing the love that you have given us. God, we thank you for each one here today and pray your blessings upon us. And God, we just want to continue to have faith in you that you're going to take care of us and watch over us. God, we pray all of this in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen.
Amen.
All right, we're ready to go.
Christian Community Outreach. Here we go. Year 34. Our food pantry is available for our Henderson County families 4 days a week and the third Saturday of the month. Yep, we're open on Saturday now, and those hours are 9 to 11. Think about that. 9 to 11, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, and the third Saturday of the month. How in the world do we serve this many families? How did we get to have 5,827 families come in for food in 2019? And we just want to be able to help our clients in any way we can. There's a verse in the Bible. It says, the body of Christ, or the people that are the whole of humanity, are a team. The body is not supported by one person,
but by all of us. We are one. We are strongest working together in unity. Teamwork is the key to living life in harmony so that we can do God's will, and thy will be done. Our food drives in the last couple of years have been amazing. Looking back at the budget, 2019 to 2018, we saved over $10,000 on food purchases. To all those who do the food drives for us, we so appreciate it. And new in 2019, oh my goodness, the golf fundraiser. What a blessing to meet Bill and Jama. All the folks that supported our golf fundraiser, just to let you know, you helped us raise $6,000 to help those in need. And then not only did we have the golf fundraiser, we were called back for the frog fundraiser. Fully rely on God. That's what we're here for, the frog fundraiser. Thank you, Bill and Jama, for another $1,500 donation from that tournament. My goodness, we're getting ready for year three of the garden. The garden has meant so much to many of our clients. It was so fun this year to give out garden passes so our clients could go out and know that they're a part of Christian Outreach and pick fresh vegetables anytime they needed to. And we can think back to Lowe's, when Lowe's come out and spend a couple days with us. They put up our new fence. Think about the extension office that come out and furnish the plants, the master gardeners that come out and planted for us, and oh, the wonderful youth groups that come out and learned how to plant vegetables and had a good lunch and just had good fun and fellowship. Back to our volunteers. Oh, volunteers, what would I do without you? Each day is a different culture in here. Each day is a wonderful group of people that get it. You know how to talk with our clients. You know how to meet their needs. You know how to give hugs. You know how to give kisses. Our clients are now our outreach family, and for that we are so very blessed. Oh, and that core group. Oh my goodness, this is new this year. Core, Christian Outreach, ready every day. What will we do without you guys? You're here 4, 5, 6, sometimes even 7 days a week. You're the core group that put away 32,000 pounds of food 1 week. Bless you, core group. Our Christmas food box program. Oh my goodness. Immediately we have sponsors for 100 food boxes. In addition to our food pantry that we do every day, let's do another 100 food boxes at Christmas. What a blessing that day is when the families come in and write thank you notes. And these thank you notes are from their heart. They're just not thank you, we appreciate it. We learn all about their situations. They are so absolutely grateful for a Christmas food box. Community involvement class, thank you. Thank you, Ms. Stovall, for your ongoing support with this program. These are cream of the crop students that we couldn't do without. Every 5 weeks, we get a new group of people that are going to go out and change the world. And they learn just a little bit about touching people's lives when they work at Christian Community Outreach. Senior Service Day, what will we do without this program? This federal program is something that 300 families here in Henderson County rely on once a month. And the best part, Christian Community Outreach pays nothing for this box of food. We are so very blessed. Hey, we're here for our clients. That's what God wants us to do. When we serve others, we serve Him, and that's why we're here. Why do we need Christian Community Outreach? Think about this, folks. Our food orders, every 30 days, our clients can come in and get food. 2017, we did 5,060 food orders. 2018, 5,222 food orders. 2019, 5,827 families had food insecurity right here in Henderson County. Folks, we need you. We need all the support we can get. Our Henderson County families are living in situations we would never, ever dream would happen to a neighbor or to a fellow coworker. These families need Christian Outreach, and we need you, and we all work as a team. Utility assistance, we helped 315 families in 2019 keep their utilities on. We're very blessed to be able to do that. Henderson Municipal Power and Light, thank you for your partnership. A grant came in for $26,000 in 2019 so we could help more families with utilities. We are so blessed. Rent assistance, it was a tough year in 2019. The fires, moving people from losing everything in their lives to moving them into a new place. Medication. Why do we still have to help people with medication? There should be money for medication. Why are people going without their insulin? Perhaps to buy food for their families. Medication, we're very happy to be able to do that. Emergency gas. How do these families take loved ones to Louisville or Indianapolis or to Nashville over and over and over? The other assistance, sometimes we get calls from schools, sometimes we get calls from Red Cross, sometimes we get calls from the Women and Children's Shelter or Harbor House. These folks need something other than what the regular assistance is here. We try to help them. We did 56 of those this year. We are just so very blessed to be in Henderson County. However, we couldn't do it without our agency partners, Volunteer and Information Center, Susan Sauls and her folks, thank you, bless you. Thank you, Brittany, and all your folks over at Habitat. We love you and we thank you for your support. Folks at Salvation Army, St. Vincent de Paul, Holy Name, oh, Pastor Burke and the Answer Center, the list goes on and on and on. And the biggest blessing of all that came in 2019, we were gifted with a plot of land at the corner of 5th and Adams. No more rent to be paid, more money for our families. We are so very blessed to have this land donation. And in 2020, you will see us break ground. You will see our building be built, and we'll be prepared to help even more folks in the coming years. What a great Henderson County that we have, that all of us come together, just like the verse said, we are one. We are strongest working together in unity. Teamwork is the key to living life in harmony so that we can do God's will. And thy will be done.
Thy will be done. I know you see.
Me to tears every time, because Miss Donna, that lady that you saw, she lives right around the corner from us where we are now. And let me tell you, if I am there past 5:30 at night, my car's there, she will call me. Mary, why are you there? Are you okay? Do you need it? Our barbers across the street from us, I'm hurrying.
No.
The barbers, Andrew and his group, they're always watching our back door. And can I? Come on, just can I? So sometimes you have to laugh, because they called and said, there's a couple at your back door and they have a sack of dogs. And I said, a sack of dogs. Okay. True story. Can't make this up. So I called dispatch. And you know, Sean McKinney took over as police chief now. Mm-hmm. Sean, I talked to him today about something. So I called dispatch and I said, I'm getting ready to leave. There's a couple out here. They've got a sack of dogs. And the dispatcher said, excuse me? I said, they got a sack of dogs. Well, they had been evicted and they were celebrating their eviction with alcohol all day, I guess. So they did have to walk away, but they are not going to leave those dogs. And there was a sack of dogs. And anyway, they were fine. They didn't cause any problems. But, you know, the world we're living in right now, it's never going to be about this brand new sparkling building. It's going to be about so many more services we can provide, just like the literacy classes. If you all don't know, this college, Jamie Gillette, if it wasn't for her working the Ready to Work program for 900 hours,
to get her nursing degree at this college, I wouldn't be at Outreach. She helped me every step of the way and worked $900, got paid to go to college, and she's an RN, has her, you know, new house, just a fantastic woman. Miyoshi, Stephanie, both of you have worked in there, the KTAP program. It's got you where you are today. There's just so many. Matthew 25, when they come in every Wednesday and do hep C testing and HIV testing, our families don't know. If you don't get tested, you will die eventually. So it's all about, you know, the addiction. You know, I've always talked about Brightview Addiction Center. It is a game changer because they will stay with you for a year and a half to 2 years. Melissa and Rhonda, they hate me because they're always on me to check my emails and all that. But no, it was Melissa Clemens that got our move, don't shake your head, from the 1,200 square foot building to where we are now, which is 3,800 square feet. If it wasn't for you all or United Way funds, we'd still be in the 1,200 foot square feet building. So, and now here we are getting ready to move into the new building. With that being said, we have extra office space. We need that extra office space all the time. We went to a wonderful presentation at Rotary with the NAACP and our lady here in town, Miss Deborah, we need you. We need you in our building so many times. We need addiction center in our building. We need staffing companies in our building. Let's make it easier. The bookmobile is coming twice a month to park in front of our building. Our families don't know what the library is. They don't feel comfortable going to the library. Let's start them at the bookmobile and then get them over there. I mean, we can just go crazy in that building. You know we can. So we are blessed. Thank you so much for letting me spend some time with you, my love.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So what I'm going to do is stop sharing the screen, and I'm going to look in the chat and see if there's any questions that you have for Ms. Durham. I want to thank you for taking the time of your day and still talking to me after Walmart to do this presentation. So anybody in the audience have any questions for Ms. Durham?
Or Dunham.
Dunham, yeah. So you know, yeah.
I'm kidding you. Who's your favorite kid? Oh my God.
I need to get this on camera. So who's your favorite kid? You got to walk over here because it's recorded.
I love all three of my children with all my heart. Jason, I love you in Fishers, Indiana, and Jake Dunham that's working today, and Kelsey Dunham, I love you. You are the reason that I am where I am today. Thank you. Was that too sappy? Okay, all right. Yeah. You all know if you have children. Yes, darling.
What can a person, you know, because I come across people who, for whatever reason, compare themselves to just people. What can a person do? What can someone do if they don't have a lot of, quote, money? Because people always think it's in terms of money. What can they do to be a blessing to Christian Outreach if it's not writing? Well, it could write a check for $5. I know you'll take it. But what else can someone do to be a blessing?
As I've said before, if I had to take you to the prayer room right now in our building, you'd have to walk through the food pantry. You'd have to go past the walk-in freezer. Actually, you can't even get in that room right now to pray. There's a gentleman that's one of our families, and he's just lost his wife, and we had our cry together. He has been a client there since I've been there. He had just showed his wife of many, many years their new apartment. She said, thank you for giving me this beautiful place to live. And she died before they moved in. And he said, she always told me that she wanted me to preach to people. I'm getting goosebumps. Because he told me this as he's sobbing. And I'm hooking him up with St. Anthony's. And I said, matter of fact, let me tell you. When you walk in the front doors of our new building, and we'll be able to tell if someone needs a prayer right now. Would you consider a two-hour shift? Because every time our doors are open,
somebody is going to be sitting in that prayer room, a dedicated prayer room with a cabinet full of Bibles. Anybody can pray with someone. And he said, are you kidding me? My wife has always told me for all these years that she thinks I should have been a pastor. And I said, you are. At Community Baptist Church, everybody takes communion. When somebody joins the church, Dr. Tim tells us we are all ministers. We are all from the same God. Everybody can pray, or you can listen. You know, anybody that's went through something and come out of something, sign up for a two-hour shift. Tell your story. It is not easy for me to tell, you know, what happened in my childhood, my sinful nature, all my wake-up calls. But you would be so surprised at the eyes that go, that happened to me too. I know. It's very common. It's very common. And please forgive me, but I say, if I miss one day of my medicine, you really don't want to be around me. It's okay to take medicine. It is not anything we ask to do, but this world has, it's okay. Let's just be real with each other. And that's, anybody can be real. And that's all I'm going to say.
All right. Dr. Warren is here. I'm giving the opportunity, as always, to get him to say his last spiel.
Okay.
I'm just going to say thank you, Mary, for sharing your story.
You're welcome.
Thank you for being so authentic with that. Thank you for your leadership. As I look around this room and everybody that's online, I see a lot of leaders, and this community does come together. And I know at HCC we see students who are dealing with a basket full of things, and it takes all of us to support them. So I look around the room, I see a lot of friendly faces, and I appreciate Dr. Spell for putting these kind of programs together, and Holly supporting everybody at HCC, and those of you coming here to support and listen. And I've enjoyed being a part of the small little ways I've been a part with your group, and we'll continue to support where we can and be a good partner here at HCC with you all. But today we're celebrating you all as leaders as well. So thanks for being here today, and thanks for what you do.
Thank you. Like I said, thank you, Mary, for taking the time of your day. And here is a token of our appreciation for you being here today.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right.
And her son called her today.
Yes, he did. I have to take care of him.
Yeah.
So, it says, Mary, it was good to see you. My sister volunteered pretty regularly, and she appreciates the wonderful work you are doing. Is there a place we can donate either money or food? And that's Trevor Harold.
Yes. Trevor, obviously you can walk in anytime. You can give it to anyone out here. Of course, I know your mom and daddy. They go to church with us. And congratulations on your new position. Did I answer your question, Trevor? I got sidetracked.
Okay, I think so. All right. Well. He said, thank you. All right. Well, if anybody have any questions that you want to ask, just feel free to send me an email and I'll make sure I send it to Mary. Bye, guys. I have some food over here.